everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Leeann, and today I'm going to do my April favorites. Don't have a lot of makeup favorites this month, so I'll just get those out of the way. My first makeup favorite is the Tarte Brush Cup, and I actually bought two of these, and I got this during the Friends and Family 25% off sale last month, and I did a Tarte haul. Actually, that was my last video, so I'll link that down below for you to watch and also add it to the end card. But I got these because they were really, really nice, and I'm actually surprised at how many brushes I do have, so I guess I was justified to buy these. These are $8 each, so I think they're a really good price for the quality of the brush cups. The shell part is really squishy, and I love that it's hot pink but has like a beautiful duochrome to it, so it kind of looks green when you turn it. This is what the back looks like. It actually holds a lot of brushes. I was really surprised to fit that many in here. If you're wondering why this one has more than this one, it's because I just use this one for the brushes that I am currently using, and then these are the brushes that I have in my collection. I actually have a lot more brushes, but I only bought two of them, so I might pick up more if I want to, but I already have some other brush holders and I don't want to waste them, and they're really nice anyway. But these are so cute. I'm so glad that I picked them up. They are still available. It's unlike what I said in my video last in the Tarte haul, because I was searching brush holder. They're not called brush holders, they're called brush cups. Anyways, yeah, so I definitely recommend picking these up if you are in the market for a brush cup or brush holders, and also because they're so cute. The next makeup product, which is actually my last one, is the Sephora Mini Color Switch by Vera Mona. And I mentioned this in, I think, my Sephora VIB sale haul video, that I picked this up because I've been getting into wearing a lot of eyeshadows lately, and I really wanted something like this actually for a whole year now, because especially since I've been traveling a lot and I don't want to bring too many brushes, which I do anyway, but you know, just dipping into so many different eyeshadows, I found that this really, really works. So basically what you do with this is you use any eyeshadow brush. This isn't an eyeshadow brush, and then you dip it into your eyeshadow and then you apply it, and then if you want to use the same brush and dip it into a different color, you just swirl it in here and it'll completely clean off this that brush, and then you can go into another eyeshadow and apply it. It's really amazing how this tiny little sponge works. It's really, really nice. I definitely recommend it if you're looking for something like this. I didn't know that this was a mini. They sell a bigger size, but I think this is perfect for traveling pretty much every day. I think this is going to last a while too, because you can just take out the sponge and then rinse it with warm water, leave it to air dry, and then put it back in here, and it's pretty much good and ready to go again. So now that we have the makeup stuff out of the way, I have a lot of skincare. Well, not a lot, but I have several skincare products that I recently introduced into my routine that I've been really, really loving for the whole month of April. This is the Dr. Jart Ceramidin Cream, and it's a nutrient-enriched cream. I love this so much. I've talked about it, I think, twice here on my channel, and I've talked about it probably a couple times on my Instagram too. What this is a moisturizer, so you use it at the end of your skincare routine. What it does is, for me, it really calms down any irritation that I have in my skin. So I suffer from eczema, and anytime I get an eczema patch here, or any time that I have like sandpapery eczema here on my jawline, I put this on and it just really soothes it. I won't say that it gets rid of the texture of eczema patches, but it definitely takes away the itchiness and it moisturizes the areas, so it's not as irritated, and it even takes away the redness. I was so surprised the first time I used it. I saw amazing results within the first use. I would say the texture of this is a little more on the oily side. I mean, I have combination oily skin, but I only use this at night, and I actually use this under makeup as well during the day, and it didn't affect my makeup whatsoever, and it didn't make me any more oily than I already get on a like regularly or normally. So I definitely think that this is so worth it. I wanted to try their green one. I forgot what it's called. Cicapair, I think. And that one has an ingredient in there that really calms down redness, so I might look into that in the future, but for now, this is probably one of the most amazing moisturizers I've ever used. And the smell of it is, like, at first when I squeezed it out, it smells a little bit like medicinal. If you are Chinese like me or Asian and you have like this like Chinese ointment that I forgot what it's, I don't even know what it's called, but it's like this brown, like soy saucy looking liquid, and you take a cotton ball and saturate it with that thing. Oh, it's for like bruises or something, and then you like rub it into your bruise, it'll go away. Like, it smells a little bit like that, but after the second time, I don't know what happened, but it doesn't smell like that anymore. I don't know, it's kind of weird. I just realized I left my monitor on in the background, so I'm just gonna turn that off. Anywho, there we go. The next one is the Drunk Elephant Sea Firm a Day Serum. This has 15% L-ascorbic acid. This actually has become my favorite vitamin C serum that I probably have ever used. I mentioned that the last vitamin C serum that I used was the Osea Malibu Brightening Serum, which I found was a very beautiful vitamin C serum. It was so silky and smooth in the, over the skin, and it definitely absorbed really quickly. But this one I saw like right away within the first use or second use or something like that, I saw results. I mean, a vitamin C serum works like short term and long term. Short term, it brightens the skin and it can fade pigmentation, dark marks, and scars. So for me, I don't know how. I popped pimples. I mentioned this in like two of my videos, but I popped pimples and then 20 minutes later, it looked like I didn't pop them at all. The redness was pretty much gone. And if you know, like when you pop pimples, those wounds, they kind of leak that gross, sticky, clear fluid. Didn't happen when I applied this after I popped the pimples. It was crazy. So I definitely recommend that you try the mini of these, of this product, because the full size one, which I did buy during the Sephora VIB sale, is $80 for about an ounce. So it is quite an investment, but I feel like if you're looking to try a brand or a product, go for a mini. This one comes with the Be Hydra Intensive Hydration Gel, which I don't want to mention in this video because it's not a favorite of mine. I'm still trying it out, but so far this one has definitely shown me results like time and time again every single time I use it. And I use this during the day. I know that a lot of people say that it smells like burnt hot dogs or something. I really don't know what burnt hot dogs smell like. It has the same smell as Paula's Choice C Booster, and I did not like that smell. I think it's like her formula might be like a little different because it smelled way stronger than this one, I think. I mean, it's not that bad, but I do find this to be a little bit sticky, but it just sinks into the skin really easily, very fast too. So you don't really feel that stickiness stay on. I mean, you're not just applying this over and then just leaving it like that. You're putting a moisturizer, sunscreen over that afterward, but it definitely is good for people with combination, more oily skin types, because I think the Osea Malibu one is probably better for those with drier skin. If you are thinking about getting a vitamin C serum or trying Drunk Elephant, I definitely recommend that you try their little minis. The next one is the Pixi Skin Treats Glow Tonic Exfoliating Toner, and this has 5% glycolic acid. It also contains aloe vera and ginseng. These products are pretty much like super hyped, and I fell for the hype, and I don't regret it. I'm really not the type of person to fall for hyped products or hyped brands or anything like that, but I love trying things, and as you can see, this is a small bottle, and I think I might invest in the bigger one in the future. I just have a lot of acids in my routine at the moment, but I really like this. The smell of it is actually quite medicinal as well. I don't know what that smell is, but it doesn't smell like so gross, but it's definitely a much stronger smell. And what it does for me is it just exfoliates my skin. And I actually, for some reason, even though this is 5% glycolic acid, my 10% glycolic acid cream that I bought from Amazon, I don't think they sell it anymore, that one is more gentle on my skin than this. So I actually can't use this every day. And I only use it at night. So I use it, I think probably at most 3 times a week, so I do it like every other day. But I do switch out my acids here and there. So this isn't my only acid product, but I really do like this. It's a great toner if you're looking for a chemical exfoliator. And I find that it's pretty gentle on the skin. It sometimes does irritate my eczema patches, but you know, eczema is just crazy like that. But I really do like it. It does give you a very nice glowy brightened look when you use it. The next one is my Skin Food Royal Honey Propolis Enriched Essence. I still use this every morning. Not every morning, I actually use this at night only. Oh my gosh, I talked about it in my last favorites, I think, and some other videos. If you are one of those people who doesn't have a lot of funds, doesn't spend a lot of money, doesn't want to spend a lot of money, then I'm pretty much the same as you. I talk about products that I've been using for a while, and I do it multiple times because I just don't have enough funds to buy a lot of products, and I love what I use. So, I mean, if I find something and I try it and then I really love it, I'll keep using it. I don't want to keep buying products over and over again. But anyways, that's not the point. I love this. It makes my skin feel so soft and so smooth, and it definitely hydrates and moisturizes and really brightens my skin. So I definitely love this so much. I used this for like a couple months or 3 months now, and it's only down to here. This is one of the best serums that I've used ever. The next one is my Lucas's Papaw Ointment. This is fresh fermented fruit. This is just papaya. I mentioned this in, oh my god, see, this is what I'm saying. I mentioned it a million times across my platforms, but this has actually surprised me a lot. I forgot what I was using this for originally, but I still use it for that purpose. But I've actually been using it on top of popped pimples to really soothe and heal them. It kind of works a lot like Neosporin. I actually had a really bad cut here. I think you can see the scar here. I actually used this instead of Neosporin the whole time with a band-aid on it, and it pretty much works exactly the same. Well, I don't know about you, but Neosporin sometimes, like, I break out in like hives a little bit. It's like really itchy. So I have been using this instead, and it's been really, really helping, especially when I pop pimples and I go a little crazy with the popping of my pimples, and it really, really helps. The redness doesn't go away, but it's like the whole irritation and the swelling and everything. It provides a protective barrier over my open wounds, so I really loved using it for that. And then my last one is the Lavera Nature Cosmetic Lip Balm, and this is in the repair one. It says it's organic, but it has organic ingredients in it, like not all of them, but this is my favorite lip balm of all time. My boyfriend actually was so nice enough to get three for me. I didn't know. Okay, I'll tell you. When I was in Germany, I mentioned this, I had really cracked sides of my mouth, like at the corners, I mean. It was so bad. It was like from the jet lag and not sleeping. We were sleeping in the morning and waking up at night. It was really, really bad. So I went to the drugstore, DM, and I picked this up, and this was the only thing that healed my lips. It's not like my sleep schedule got better or got worse, but this was definitely the thing that saved my life. It was so painful to open my mouth and eat and talk. I didn't know that this is actually sold at like Whole Foods and some other like health food stores. I thought this was like exclusively like a German brand, but I'm so happy that I have three now. I mean, I could obviously go to Whole Foods and like buy more, but what, I have three now. It's pomegranate, but it smells nothing like pomegranate. Like, I don't know, it just smells like a balm, but it feels so silky going across the lips. It just melts right into your lips like an oil, like a butter, and it stays on your lips pretty much all day and all night. And I definitely love to reapply this throughout the day and use it at night as a like an overnight lip treatment. And every time I wake up, my lips are always so soft and plump, and I love to use this before I apply any of my lip products too, like today. Oh, actually, that wasn't my last one. This is my last skincare product, and this is the Tatcha, I forgot what this is called, I keep forgetting, like Kinu Pure Silk Polishing Face Cloth, I think. I want to say that I did a video showing how I use this, I think, yeah, when I was using three of their sample products that I got during a sale last year. And I started to use this with the Clinique Take the Day Off Cleansing Oil and Cleansing Milk. This works fantastic. for taking off your makeup. I find that it works best with the One Step Pure One Step Camellia Cleansing Oil, whatever it's called, from Tatcha. Those go hand in hand, but I don't want to dish out money for that cleansing oil since I have so many other ones, but it works fine with the Clinique ones. What you do is you do, like, the first time with your oil, you massage it into your skin, break down all the oil, and then you wet this, and then you wrap it around two fingers, and then just gently exfoliate your skin as you're removing the cleansing oil or milk off. And it works so well. I feel like I'm getting a much deeper clean than just using my hands and then rinsing it off with water. I follow it up with my Foreo and cleanser and everything like that, but I feel like my skin is just so much cleaner ever since I started using this. I don't want to recommend it because it's quite expensive. It lasts for a whole year. You don't even have to wash it. Every time you use it, you just rinse it with warm water and then you leave it to air dry and then store it in like a plastic bag like me or whatever you want to store it in. I don't know if you can get the same results from a microfiber cloth or a muslin cloth. I haven't tried that, but because I have this, it's definitely been working really well for me. I forgot to mention that there's a skincare thing. It's not a particular product, but I have been using the Wamisa flower essence. Basically, I have been doing the three skin method. If you don't know what that is, it is a huge craze in Korea. You use your essence, like you pour it out onto your hand and you pat it into your skin. You repeat the process 3 or 7 times. And I tried to do it 7 times like last year and I did not like it because it was just layering so much product into my skin, and I'm so oily already. I think it did the adverse, like reverse effect, and it totally irritated my skin. But I started to do the three skin method last month because my skin was just going crazy. Like, it's the spring, but it was so cold, like it was still the winter, and then now it's like super hot. So doing the three skin method for me definitely kept my skin super hydrated and very glowy without weighing it down with so many layers of it. So if you want me to do a video on the three skin method, then I can totally do that for you. I was already thinking about doing something like that. So definitely stay tuned for that. Now for some lifestyle favorites. I have been really enjoying my sleep mask. I got this on Amazon and it comes in a pack of 3, which sucks because I can't even find the other 2, so I might have to put in another order for another one. But this is my favorite sleep mask of all time. I only ever had those free ones they give to you when you're flying, or I remember I ordered 2 pajama sets from Victoria's Secret like 3 years ago. Those 2 sets came with their respective sleep masks, but this is blackout. This is truly a blackout sleep mask. And it's so funny because it makes you look like a fly. I love how it's stretchy, like the straps are really stretchy, so you can adjust it however tight you want or how loose you want it. And I love that it has like memory foam in here, so it's very soft and it's plushy. And this little nose thing here, I will say that the gap is quite big. So I face my window in my room, and when the sun comes out, I can see the light from this crack here, but it's not that bad. Either way though, this has been saving my life. I have insomnia. It's so crazy, and especially because it's gotten so much hotter. It's gotten hot here in New York City. The sun is so much brighter, and this actually saved me from waking up a million times this morning from the sunlight. This comes in purple, blue, and black. I've been using this for about 2 months now, and it's basically changed the way I sleep. If you have insomnia like I do, it's so bad. I don't even sleep until like 7 o'clock in the morning sometimes. I recommend that you read my blog posts. I'll link everything down below. I give you 11 tips on how to manage your insomnia. I don't have cures for anything. There's like no cure for anything, but I have so much experience with insomnia. I've suffered from it for I don't even know how many years, like over a decade basically. And I just have some ways on how to manage it. So definitely give that a read. This was one of the tips that I mentioned, is just to invest in a sleep mask. And because it comes in a pack of 3, you'd think that it's a lot of money, but it actually wasn't a lot of money. I think it was like $12 or $15 or something. But invest in your health, please. I love talking about beauty products, but just everything that I do, everything that I want to promote on my channel is self-care. Whatever you want to do, do it for yourself and make sure that your health is your priority. And so investing in a sleep mask like this was definitely the best investment that I made so far this year on myself. I wanted to mention that no longer need a heater, but this is something that I used all last month because, all last month because it was so cold, and my mom actually gave me this heater to me like 2 months ago when I came back from my trip from Germany. It's the only thing that was keeping my feet from freezing and falling off. This is a little portable heater by Vornado, and it has a dial here for how hot you want it, and then there's a low, a medium, and a high dial here. A button, and then the on and off button here. It works so well. It heats up so fast. This was definitely my lifesaver. Basically, I could use it anytime that my feet feel really cold and not have to turn up the heat in the house and waste energy like that. So I definitely have been loving my little space heater. And then my other lifestyle favorite is actually my desk. It's so funny. I like sit in front of my drinks here and my coconut oil. But this is my new desk. I'll stand up. I got this last month. Actually, you can see that I'm wearing pajama pants, but Staples does not sell desks anymore in store. They sell it online. They sell them online, and this is where I got mine. It's so nice. It has, like, I don't even know what kind of wood this is, like, what color. Is it cherry mahogany or something? Of course, it's, like, fake wood. But it has a tempered glass tabletop, which is so nice. But because I'm really clumsy, my mom decided to buy these placemats for me from Bed Bath & Beyond, just so I don't break anything. But I love that it has, like, this little, like, shelf here for my monitor, my speakers. Like, it looks so much cleaner than my desk was before. So much cleaner. And I really love it. Like, if you see down here in my computers there, I really like that whole look. Like, you put all your computer stuff on the floor of it, so, you know, like, your computer's not sitting, like, on the floor. And I love that it also has wheels, so you can move it in case you want to vacuum or, I don't know, replace it in the future. So I have been really, really enjoying my desk. It's so nice. The only thing I don't like about it is that the keyboard drawer sits so low, and my chair, because I'm so short, your eye length needs to be pretty much at the top of your monitor, and my knees, they just keep hitting the keyboard. I mean, I love it, whatever. Can't do anything about it, can I? Another favorite of mine, I'm just gonna pull my phone off the charger. I'm not ever going to like iPhones. I am still an Android fan and probably will forever be. This is my new iPhone 8. I have been loving playing Tamagotchi, my Tamagotchi Forever. I love playing it. I was so obsessed with it all last month. Not so much anymore. It's just your updated Tamagotchi. If you guys have ever played Tamagotchi back then you know, 90s forever. Obviously, everything has been updated. They still have poop, and everything is 3D now, obviously. So I'm just gonna close this because they make, like, the most obnoxious sounds. It's really fun, though. Really, really fun. You have some mini games in there. It is very repetitive, as most of these apps are these days, but I think we just like, you know, constant stimulation, and you can basically play that for a while. Of course, you have to stop when you run out of energy, but you just have to watch an ad. You have to watch an ad for everything now, so I have been really enjoying playing that. I wanted to talk about a fitness thing. Fitness has always been a very important part of my life, and I actually wanted to become a physical therapist, but I am so not into science. It's like I can tell you what you should do or something like that, or why it works, but I can't tell you, like, muscles and, like, getting really technical with the science. I can't do that. But anyways, I love Women's Health. It's my favorite magazine that I've ever subscribed to. This is the only one I'm still subscribed to. And in their latest issue with Anna Faris on the cover, they always have workouts in here. In this particular issue, they talk about LIIT. So instead of HIIT workouts, it's a LIIT workout. And it stands for lower intensity interval training. It actually makes so much sense that when you are doing HIIT workouts, you're just using up so much more of your energy because your rest periods are very short. So you may do like 45 seconds of work and 15 seconds off, and then you keep doing that. So you don't have enough time to recover in between moves. So what I really like about this is that it It has supersets in there, which means that you have two workouts or two moves that you do back to back. You rest 1 minute in between each move, and then when you finish both moves, you rest for 2 minutes and then you repeat it two more times, so for a total of three sets. So I've been doing this since, I think, for a week now, and I've seen results, and it was so fast. You just wouldn't think that if you rested for a longer period of time that you're, I don't know, building more muscle than if you just worked, but it really helps your form. And any physical therapist and physical trainer will tell you that the most important part about fitness is your form. So you have to be really careful about how you perform each move to prevent injury. So I have been really enjoying this. If you would like to see a fitness video, I can't really do much of those because I have to film myself, but I can definitely do that in the future. I will definitely do a blog post about this workout and some other workouts that I have been doing and will continue to do for the next month, because my fitness goals are just, I guess, a lot more different than a lot of people's on, like you see on Instagram. I'm not here to lose weight. I'm just here to build muscle, and I'm even here to like gain a little bit of weight, but my fitness goal has always been to gain more muscle, and then with more muscle I gain weight, etc., etc. But I just love fitness so much. It's a very integral part of my well-being. That was it for my video. I wanted to be really short, but I don't know what happened. I really hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know down below what your April favorites are and recommend products for me to try out, and give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Subscribe to see more videos from me. I'll leave all my social media platforms down below, and I hope to see you in my next video. Bye.